It's November. We're going to stay in Colorado for a month. We're spending one of the weekends at the YMCA of the Rockies. Check-in time was supposed to be at 6 p.m., but we were given our room keys at 1:30 during non-peak season. Breakfast is included in most reservations. The Rustic Cafe is one of the options inside the registration building. There are only a few dining options on site, and the restaurants may not be open at the same time, so do get an updated schedule when you checked in. There is a convenience store located at the administration building. Based on normal schedule, the store should be open from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. But during my visit under non-peak season, they were closing at 7 p.m. If your kids loved animals, this is the perfect place to be. I encountered more deer and elks here at YMCA than when I was in Yellowstone. I suggest signing up for the treasure hunt activity during a check-in or by calling ahead of time. The activity is a guided tour. You and your kids will try to look for treasure chest stickers in different buildings and locations. After the activity, you will get to know the place very well. There are tons of programs to sign up for. To make reservation and to check out equipments, simply stop by the Sweet Memorial Program building. There are other attractions that your kids may love. Do make sure you make your reservations early. The roller skating rink is used for archery during the day, and there's no prior experience required. After dinner, we came back to the same place and we brought the time back to the 80s. The heated pool is open year round. I'm sure you'll find some time to enjoy. There's not going to be towels provided at the pool. If you're using the one from your room, make sure you return it properly. If your kids love arts, for additional cost, you can do many different types of projects at their art center. If you're staying multiple days, I suggest to stop by the art center on the very first day. So it gives you enough time to do more projects and pick up the end products. For those who come to hike, if you may need last minute supplies, check out their gear shop. They also have a hiking information desk that can provide you information about different trails. In between activities, we managed to find some time to visit the museum. They have tons of things that your kids may not have seen before. From there, you'll find the very first set of rules for basketball. You'll also be able to find a very early prototype of an iPhone. After checking out the museum, if you still have extra time, it's about time to talk to the deers again. During our visit, we stayed at the Emerald Mountain Lodge. The rooms are not comparable to a luxury hotel such as Hilton or Marriott, but the room was very clean and spacious. It was also very comfortable. I had a 2 queen bedrooms as usual, and the rate was about $89 including breakfast. If I have not mentioned it before, some of the activities we walked through earlier are fully covered in your reservation, so there's no extra charge. At the time of our visit, one of the dining options we had was the all-you-can-eat buffet at the Aspen Dining Room. In breakfast time, you can either go to Rustic Cafe for a to-go package, or you can come back for an all-you-can-eat options again. Your activities are not limited inside YMCA. There are tons of things to discover within the Estes Park boundaries. Stop by the National Park Service office for more park information. There could be traffic by the park entrance. Try to get there early or plan some extra time in your schedule. We only had a short weekend here, so we only managed to visit Sprague Lake and Bear Lake. The trail is very flat and it is very kids friendly. I think it took us about 30 to 40 minutes to complete the whole loop. We were also very lucky to be able to stop by Bear Lake before sunset. But we did not have enough time to finish the hike. If you happen to be there, please tell us more about it in the comment sections. Thank you. We were already very happy about seeing all those deers inside YMCA. But you may find new surprises when you come to downtown Estes Park. It is not advised to stay that close to an elk, but since she was probably coming to promote Christmas to us, we couldn't resist to stay for a few more minutes for a picture. On the way to Estes Park, you will also find very interesting shops around. I was going to check out on some good deals for my favorite snacks, but my daughter insists on visiting this stuffed toy store that almost have everything she needs. If you are craving for ice cream, you will find what you need in every single corner. And there are shows to entertain you while you're having your dessert. Our last stop was at Stanley Hotel. Too bad we didn't have enough time to have a cup of coffee here. But we had a lot of fun with the outdoor maze. Please make sure to check it out with your kids. And that is all I have to share for now. If you think my video is helpful, please subscribe and like. See you next time.